early hours of the morning, 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, I was having a good sleep, but I just sort of, something was disturbing me, so I laid in bed and I was listening, and out in the distance I could hear a cow bellowing, and I thought, you know, born and bred on the land, I heard a lot of cows bellowing, and usually if they had something wrong with a calf or whatever, it just sounded upset. So I laid there for a while, and then I could hear this sort of a droning sound. I started to get a bit more of a focus on where it was actually coming from, and I realised it was a lot closer to the house than I expected. It was moving around the side of the house. So with that, I still didn't take much notice. Then I started to hear a couple of the dogs on the veranda was bristling up and starting to growl a little bit and carrying on, and I thought, geez, something's upsetting the dogs. So I thought, don't know what's going on here, but so I still didn't take much notice. The next minute I heard the dogs getting really upset. They started to growl and bark and carry on, and on the veranda there was no railing around the veranda. Mm-hmm. It was an open top timber decking on the veranda. Off memory, there was an old timber table and a couple of chairs there, and on the wall of the corrugated iron hut was a piece of timber with a platform on top. We used to feed the magpies and the young maggies, and they put a bit of mince up there and whatever. Amongst all this, I heard a bit, the dogs got really upset and they started growling and barking and carrying off. I thought, crikey, what's going on here? Next minute there was this almighty thud and banging at this door, and a hell of a racket started up, and I thought, cross, the dogs had got into a fight or something. So I flew out of bed in the darkness and I got to the door, and there was a light switch right next to it. I hit the light switch, and when I went to open the door, I expected these dogs to be out on the veranda having a fight between themselves, and there was a hell of a noise going on. So I went to open the door, and as I got the door open a little bit, one dog came bowling straight past me, nearly, you know, smacked into my legs, and then flew into the room, and it was all frothed up in the mouth, and it was hackles were up. At that moment I was yelling out to say, sit down, and then straight outside the door I could see where the wall stepped in a bit. The other dog, which was my good pig dog, it was backed up in the corner and screaming and carrying on. I was terrified. And as I started to yell out, sit down, I looked up in front of me, and the last thing I expected to see was a light shone out onto the veranda.
Yeah.
Was this thing that was standing only about 3 or 4 metres in front of me, right on the end of the veranda.
Yeah.
It was just standing, it wasn't doing anything particular, but it had thrown some of the chairs off the veranda and ripped down the timber plank that was against the wall, which we used to feed the magpies on. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, of course, I was absolutely dumbfounded. I just sort of stood there with my mouth open, the dogs were screaming, one dog was back inside the room, and this thing, which was on the end of the veranda, was basically just standing there, and with that it spun around, took a couple of leaps, and then jumped off the end of the veranda and disappeared into the darkness. Obviously, you know, I was pretty shocked at what I seen.
Yeah.
I gathered myself after a while, couldn't believe it. I expected to see two dogs having a fight, or a roo would come in or something like that, but certainly not what I did see. Yeah, it sort of put me back a peg. I didn't get much of a sleep that night. But, I've been in the bush all my life, and it was nothing that I'd ever seen or witnessed before, but it was probably somewhere around about the, say, 5'8", 5'10", quite solid build. It was gingery coloured, to had gingery sort of brown, longish hair, quite a heavy set animal. The facial features I couldn't really make out because of the lighting, of course, was pretty poor. But I mean, that, you know, you'd never ever expect to see one. Probably go for the rest of my life and never see it. And I said, I've spent most of my life in the bush.
Yeah.
You know, and the last thing I expected, as I said, to see that thing was on the end of the veranda. At that stage I realised it was only metres from the house, and it was travelling around the house, and once it got around to where the dogs were, it was on. But it had to be reasonably strong to tear that. It was a piece of 4x2 hardwood that was on the wall, and it was nailed on with, you know, 5-inch nails, and it just ripped them off. I could hear the cow bellowing in the distance, which was what first got my attention, you know. Because when you're on the land all your life, you hear a cow bellowing, you go and check, especially around calving time or whatever.
Yeah.
And that's what woke me to start with, was I could hear this cow, and she was pretty upset.
Yeah.
And she was just running up and down the fence line bellowing. Yeah. But for my dogs, I've never in my life ever seen dogs that upset.
Yeah.
They were in a bit of a state, the hackles are right up on them, and they were just not barking anymore, but screaming, you know. Well, these dogs, they were just terrified, mate. You know, one of them, as I said, comes by, and as soon as they had the door open 6 inches, it just hit the door and it knew there was a way out. But the other poor dog, he was jammed because the door had, from the doorway, you had around about 2 feet of wall, and then he was jammed in the corner, and he was just laying back, screaming his head off, the poor bugger. But it was quite an amazing thing for me to see. As I said, I didn't expect to see that at all.